like the Vendetta's clay.
Yeah. I forgot about this, the media scrums. Put my dentist appointment for 11:15 and then got the heads up that I had to come here. Totally forgot about it, so I'm going to be late for my dentist and I might not have enough out for a week.
Is the middle of May always the date for you, penciled in on the calendar, or is it sooner than you thought?
I never had a date in mind, like I said all along. It was a matter of when I felt right, and as soon as I felt right, I'd get back out there and play, and obviously I feel pretty good now, and I've got the opportunity to play this weekend.
Knee's okay, but is the head right, mate?
Yeah, it's good. Both are good. It's been a tough time, obviously a very long time at that. And now I'm just so excited to be part of the team and being named in the side to face the Lions. And it's going to be a massive challenge, but at the same time, I feel like I played the game. Four challenges, and this is one.
You said a couple of weeks ago you thought you were probably ahead of schedule, and you had to pull yourself back. That's really pretty hard for a sportsman to do when you're day in, day out, watching blokes training, teammates training.
That's the toughest thing about this job. It's something that we do day in and day out, and then if you're so far ahead of schedule and then all of a sudden you put back a little bit, you find it very hard to mentally just switch off a little bit and rest yourself, because that's what we do. We push ourselves to the limit day in and day out. We train to better ourselves. Every time we hit the gym, every time we set foot on the field, and we're out there to improve. And sometimes improving means rest, and that's what I did for a few weeks.
So why do you hope to get through 80 minutes this weekend, or maybe 60 or so?
It's not really up to me. There's a medical staff and a coach here, depending on tactics. I'll play as much as I can, and hopefully just get out there and play some good footy. It's not about how long I can play. It's about getting out there and strapping the boots on and really going out there to prove a point that the last 6 months have been worthwhile building up my body and making sure that I'm right to go.
What can the fans and the team expect, Quade? I mean, the jink and the swerve, the sidestep, that's part of your arsenal, a major part of your arsenal. Is that going to be, are you going to see that this weekend, or is it going to slowly ease back with the confidence?
Confidence isn't something that I lack, so going out there and playing footy is what I love to do. So you never go out there on the field to go and step someone on purpose. You go out there and play the game, but if those opportunities arise, I know that I've done the hard work out in the field to, and that my body will be able to do those things. But and saying that, I've got to get out there. It's still only Wednesday, so I've got to get out there on Saturday, strap the boots on, and warm up, and get out there with my teammates, and just do the job.
It's difficult. You've got quite a lot during the World Cup, off the field. How did you handle that sort of mentally? Like, it was really quite. You seem to be subject to quite a bit of torment. Is that difficult to handle?
I wish you handle it any other way, that if someone was tormenting you, like if I was to go and say something about you, you'd probably just laugh it off or get on with your life. You're not gonna go home and cry about it. And so it's something like that. Someone's gonna say something, people are gonna have their opinions, but get on with life, mate. I'm in a very privileged position. I've got great people around me, a great team, and I've got a great opportunity on the weekend to go out there and resume my team and hopefully go back to back again. The boys have been playing some great footy, and I just want to be a part of that.
Quade, you're a very positive, confident guy, but have you gone through tough times with the knee, with the rehab, all that sort of, has there been demons you've had to overcome sort of thing?
For sure. It's been a long time on the sidelines, and when you're seeing your teammates and stuff training and out in the field and kicking the ball around and you can't do much, you're sitting there with basically being able to limp down to training and watch and walk out in the field, grab a footy and stuff like that. So it is tough, because playing footy is what I love to do, but in the same respect, you gotta look at the long run and think, this is a challenge, this is something that I've got to overcome to get back out there and be with the boys and doing those fun things that we enjoy to do. So sitting on the sidelines, I had its tough times, but again, it's the support and the people that I've had around me, my family, my friends, the fans as well, they've been great. So it's been a long time, it's been a difficult one, but it's same time, it's been one that I've enjoyed. But injuries are something that you wouldn't wish upon anyone, and hopefully that won't happen again.
Great. Does the confidence extend to 2 weeks to make a crack at the test zone?
Well, that's not my focus at all. Like, it's my focus is solely getting out there and this weekend and playing good footy. If those things arise, then we'll think about them when they come. But it's still a long way away from me. But when you've got an injury, don't look too far ahead. You look at the things that are right in front, and that's playing the Lions on the weekend.
You mentioned before about proving the point as far as backing up the work that you've done off the field. Do you feel like you've got to prove the point as well, just to show the form that you had last year quickly, and also, I guess, the disappointment of not playing the best in the World Cup?
Every time you take the field, you go out there to prove a point. You don't go out the field to make up numbers. You go out there to prove that you deserve to wear that jumper. You go out there to prove that you are the best in that position, and you're facing an opposition who are out to show that they're better than you, basically. And I know on the weekend that the Lions will be coming for me, they'll be coming for the team, and they're at the bottom of the ladder at the moment, so they're going to be wanting to show that they're a team worthy of being in the competition, and they're going to want to play some great football against us. So mentally, we've got to come prepared for that, and that's just, not just me personally, that's the whole team. So as a team, we're going to be out there to prove things, but personally, every time I step on the field, I'm going to prove that I'm the best in my position.
Ewen, what a fillip for the team heading into such an important phase of the campaign.
Yeah, we're probably a little bit lucky because Quade's been in around training for the last month, I suppose, so we've already had the habit of his, I've always talked about his communication, his calling school, all that. We've been seeing it, so anyway, we've already been benefiting from that. But yeah, it's good to be able to get him back on the field. In the end, he's been a really good player for us, and it's difficult. We've got a bunch of guys in rehab who've done in similar circumstances, and watch them. It's quite a difficult time. Quite a bit more public than a couple of other guys in the same boat, so it's difficult. And you watch him struggle, but he's come out the other side in good shape, good mental health, which is the important part, and ready to be able to play like we know he can play. And in my time here, the Reds, he's played a lot of different football, so I'm looking forward to seeing that.
Mike Harris, still the first choice kicker. Or you
Well, I think one of the things you've got to do is accept, quite would like to bring everything on the weekend because that's his nature, but at the same time, we need to understand he's come off a 6 month layoff, so we won't be loading up too many things other than getting out there. But the communication piece and the organisational piece is the bit that we're really looking forward to, and we'll concentrate on that, and then we'll just build the repertoire after that. Mainly is getting out there, get through a period of the game, and make sure he comes off in good spirits, and we'll build from there.
I think was there a bit of temptation to just put him on the bench easy at the start?
Oh, I think that's one way of doing it. We've already been injured. Injured players. You don't know how long they can play for. He's been out for a long time. So, and the other part is that the starting 15 is the training time. So he's actually integrated in a short week. The best way to do it, and to be honest, he's been around what we've been the last month anyway. So yesterday was a putting him in there and Train Wilson made a decision after training to start that way and go with it. But you can do it different ways, but I think the right way to do is to get out there and play as long as we can. And then we've got good options in the round, so we can just walk as we go. But unreasonable to think we can get out there and play 80 minutes. We're going to manage the fatigue piece and we haven't played for a while. Fatigue comes in, that's when you and lose some of the control aspects, so we want to make sure that the flow's fresh and that we manage that well, so that it's a bit of clean in terms of time.
But Luke is a fullback, so that means Quade had his role like last year, playing as the pretenders on the
bench. No, not necessarily. We'll work through that. We've got some different strategic ideas. We haven't played the Lions. The Lions have actually kicked the ball, I think, on the least in the competition, so it's a different circumstances the last few weeks, so we've got some ideas about that. But Ben Lewis has been playing pretty well, and he's a playmaker of that right, so gives us an opportunity to do some things as well.
Is that Quade at the front line?
Probably where he needs to be. Part of the comeback is you do what you have to do, and money you get all night. So we're not that good. We walk straight to the game, and we can move people around that well. And in front of the circumstances in front of you, you've got a complicated team you play against. A lot of things they do that aren't unpredictable. And yeah, they don't have maybe the wins on the board that a normal team play. And so we're not going to go and go.
Sorry, what did you like about the game against the Chiefs last weekend? You're pretty close to the action with a highly paid water boy.
I'm doing
the
water boy for free, actually.
I enjoyed the whole game. It was a very tough game from a onlooker on the sideline. Very physical, there was a lot of running, and to come away with the win was the most important part of it. Confidence-wise, I could see that shoot through the team, and to be behind by such a large margin, and then to be able to come back against arguably the best team in the comp at the moment. So, confidence-wise, that it goes a long way into where we want to be moving forward. But yeah, like that, when Billy scored that try, I was just about running on the field. So. I didn't want to get too close, but as soon as he scored it, it's just a bit of a reminder of the last year's grand final.
And obviously a lot has been said about confidence, you being a confidence player. How long ago was it that the medics said that you were right to play and it was just you being confident in your knee? That was when the medics said, yep, you're all good, because obviously you've been around for the past month running the post, obviously you made contact, but the medics hadn't previously said anything prior to that.
Well, it's, the medics, they can say, structurally my knee was fine a long time ago, but then you've got to do a lot of work from then on in to make sure it stays that way. So muscle-wise, control-wise, and then the last thing is confidence. So there was never a time that they said, all right, here you go, you can go out there and play now, it's a matter of up to you, but basically you've got to tick a lot of boxes. And obviously the final box was ticked yesterday, and then therefore I was selected in the team to play this weekend. So I'm just excited to play, and I think that's where my sole focus is going to be.
Is your speed and agility at the optimum levels, or is it still a way to go there? I mean, what's your testing?
I know, you have to come out to train and watch. Now I'm feeling like I'm in good shape. I've done all the right things off the field in terms of diet, looking after my body. Cause, one thing I learned about injuries from I injured a knee when I was 18, and I didn't look after my body too well, and a six-month injury turned into basically a 12-month injury because I didn't look after my body. So when I come back, I was about 98 kilos. I couldn't run. I was getting sore every time I ran. And my skin folds were up, and mentally you go out there and you think, well, I'm supposed to be able to do these things and I can't, why can't I do them? And it's basically from not taking care of your body, and your body is your equipment, and the field's our workplace, and to make sure that my body, my equipment's in the best possible nick. I've done that through diet and training though.
What are some things that you might have given up diet-wise, or it's just everything in moderation, or how stringent than you have to be?
Well, I'm a bit of a peanut butter fanatic and a chocolate fanatic as well, so I haven't really given up too much, but it's a matter of if you're going to do those things, train hard, and then in moderation as well. I pretty much eat peanut butter, chocolate and ice cream nearly every day, but I don't go out there and just sit around home and put a tub of ice cream and just eat that. You've got to go out there, you've got to train hard, you also got to eat well outside those times, and my diet's pretty sound otherwise, apart from those few little things there, but it's basically just treating some.
Are you missing not to be gulping in a second?
No, really, Mikey showed throughout the year, he's a class goalkeeper, and he's been hitting them very well. I'm coming back from a pretty long layoff, so I wouldn't expect to just walk out there and take the tee off him and start kicking goals, but I've got to keep practicing that, and if the time arises when I need to take a shot at goal, I've got to be able
how to hit that kick and have be confident in my ability of taking those kicks. So I'll just continue to practice, and it's all about game time. It's not about going out there and wanting to kick goals. I just got to do my part, which is getting out on the field and playing football.
You talked about how the contract negotiations sort of played on his mind and affected his game. Are you the type that can just put that to one side and go out there and not bother with it?
Well, contracting's totally out of my control. All I have to do is go out there and play good football, concentrate on my job, which is playing rugby, and my manager's job, which is to sort out my contract with Ewen and Jim Carmichael as well. So that's not my focus. I'll leave that job to the people who are in the position to do that, and I'll do my role, which is wear the number 2 jersey for the
rest. Ewen, will you look to have Quade play as much as possible, first receiver and first play, or give Ben and Mike the opportunity to take the load off?
Obviously, quite play that role, but from the way the game pans out, the other people have to step in every time. So depends on which side of the ruck is playing or whatever. I mean, we've already seen, already know that Will plays as a playmaker as well in some respects. So you don't have any limitations on who can be the first receiver. But obviously, Quade's out there because he's been communication piece we've been talking about, the actual articulated game out there, how we play it, and Quade's been our best exponent. Got other guys who I think Ben and Lucas done a really good job stepping up, and Quade does it naturally the best, and that's why we're having that one.
Ewen, he said at the start of the week it was a bit of a miracle from the start. What actually?
Miracles happen. we had a, I've monitored Quade and all our new players. I do remember it was only about 3 or 4 weeks ago, we had enough players, and we were scratching around. So as it is, we've been playing with the back line with only one spare player for the last 4 weeks, so it's great to have players come back. We've already seen the impact of Anthony coming back and Bigby, and so the quality players, the guys that have been there in the tough moments and the hard moments the last few years, to have them coming back in is great. But we've monitored it, and it's been everything I've told you. It's been we discuss the medical situation all the time. We're in new structure, Quade was in good shape. He had a setback, so that obviously slowed all that thinking down. So we've been cautious in that space. And then it's just a matter of really seeing him on the field. And I can tell watching him if he's unencumbered. And at that point, we had a discussion. We had things around contact which still needed to be done, and they've been done in the last 48 hours. And so we think, okay, it's all done. In the end, we made a decision we can wait another week or wait another 3 weeks. In the end, if his mindset's right and he's kicked the boxes, we'll be on. That's what we saw. Quade, that touch reset back, did it put you back a few weeks? And when you first sort of woke up that next morning, did it spine look a bit swollen? What was going through your head at the time?
Well, my first reaction was, what is it? It hurt a bit. Like, it wasn't like it's just like a massive pop or anything. Like, when I hurt my knee initially, it was just pulled up sore, there was no swelling or anything, so it wasn't too serious, but if you're getting pain, then something was going to be wrong. So sought out the right people, saw the surgeon, saw our physio and everything, and then it was a matter of just having a bit of rest. And like I said earlier, sometimes rest is the best thing for you, and as a sportsman, you always want to push yourself, so it's kind of hard to pull back. So when I had about 2 weeks or a week or so of just doing nothing, and basically just turning up to sessions, not doing too much, and then after a week or so I felt good, and then I've been back in the gym last week and running around, and I just felt refreshed by having just a week off. So sometimes you actually have to listen to the strength and conditioning. So.
And contact work, or are you still going to do that, or have you done any contact work, or are you still going to do that?
Yeah, I've done a bit of contact, and so we've got a big session with Salvo as well, so that's why I said it's a matter of getting through the week and not just thinking straight towards the game. If things happen from now until the game, I just want to make sure that I do the right things, and to make sure that every time I step out onto the field, even the track training paddock, I'm out there to improve myself. Whether that be take a bit of contact, work on my passing, my kicking and everything like that.
and that will all start to come and lead into the game this week.
I think obviously with this players coming back from form against the Chiefs as well, it's good signs 5 games out from the finals, really, isn't it?
Yeah, no, well, we knew eventually when we get some players back, we'd be able to get injured, so eventually that's a good thing to have in the competition, so we did get a second win, but now we just have to hang in there. We've never really lost our way. It's been difficult, but it's never really lost our way. We're just really, all the hard work, the team's been strong. We just haven't, we've had to adapt, we've had to play around with the even tactically, and work through that situation, but we've actually done pretty well. And we've played three teams and traveled 2 wins and a close loss. So, I think we've got ourselves in a good space, and I could tell from the playing group they were expecting the expectation of winning was there. So, it's been great to evaluate with the experienced players coming back in and just adding voice. Training and just organisation. It's just all the subtle little things. People think it's magic big things. It's all little things that make a difference. It's just the experience and communication is a big piece on the field, And then having guys that know and been there and done that before makes a big difference. So to be able to bring that, more of that in is a good time.
You got Chris set to make his debut off the bench, just reward for working with training camp?
Just thought he's a really exciting young prospect, so it's nice to do it. The old heads like Quade coming in, not that old, but the experienced players coming in. This sort of two is, he's only 8, just turned 18. He's a player of the future, no question about that. He's got lots of skills. So I'm as excited about him getting an opportunity to learn about some Quade. I think he's a really good player. He's had a history of hamstring issues, which we spent a lot of time getting right through school more football. And I think we've done a lot of work on that. Very powerful player, and there's lots of good things going on. We obviously know that William Bills, the world, whenever they're really making a mark, he's only 19. And Dom Shipley's had a great season, he's a leading try scorer. So there's good things been going on while we've been struggling. But to have Quade and the likes of Chris coming in is good news for us.
Good. Put it in some trouble. Here or